Hello and welcome to Military Mantra. In this interview, we have today Colonel Rajiv Barwan, who has served in the Indian Army for close to 22 years. And in this interview, we'll try to understand his journey of joining the Indian Army, life in the Indian Army, and various life lessons that he has learned over his service. So welcome, sir, and thank you for coming on this interview and in this session to discuss with us your journey and also answer a lot of questions from the aspirants.
Akash, thank you very much. Jai to you and everyone who is on the board. In fact, it is a pleasure and an honor to come on live and share my experiences with you. Pleasure is all mine. Thank you so very much, Akash.
Yeah. Sir, if you could, start telling us, how was your journey before joining the Forge and what motivated you back then to join the Forge and become an officer?
Okay. I'll talk straight on this. There was nothing very extraordinary. I was just like any other guy who's just next door and a very simple guy. College going, first I completed my school. I was a KV product and did my schooling from BSF Senior Secondary School, Tekkenpur. Like any other simple guy, I also had a lot of friends and had the same taste. Padhai karni hai, thoda khelna hai, thodi badmashi karni hai. Was like that. And outdoor activities was always very good. Subsequently came to the college. In college, the basic thing which was, I always wanted to join army, NDA I tried, but I tried only once. But I could not clear it. The reason was simple. My maths was absolutely a disaster, I believe. It was absolutely bad. I tried, I worked very hard, but I could not make it. So I never tried after once because I knew I will not be able to do it. I worked very hard, but maths was actually what to do. In addition to that, I was although confident, but then I was very extremely shy. Few of my classmates are also on the air at the moment. I'm sure they are watching me and listening to this. They can testify. I was very shy guy, extremely shy. With regards to the communication skill, I could communicate, but there was a strong fear of speaking in front of the public. Okay. But when I came to the college, I joined NCC. And before college, I was traveling from station A to B because my father was a BSF officer. So I was with him, switching all stations. And finally, I landed up in Hisar, my hometown in Haryana, and I joined NCC. Now, this was the transformation era. I knew this is one something which I wanted like anything. And if I don't join army, I probably will die. I never wanted to miss on this. So I started working on that. I joined NCC. That was one major factor. In addition to this, I started working upon my communication skills and other skills. And I worked really very hard. Very hard. Although I was NCC entry, but I never availed that facility. I worked hard. The idea was ki what I could not do during the NDA time, I have to clear in the CDs. So in first go, I worked day, night and out. I cleared my exams, went for the SSB and cleared it in one go. Now, your second question, what motivated me to join army? Okay. To be very honest, the biggest inspiration and the role model for me always have been my father. He was a BSF officer. And as I was growing, I had always seen him as an exemplary role model in whatever thing. I had always seen him leading from the forefront. I'd seen him, he was extremely good with his men. The people, the way used to respect him and more than that, they used to love him. So initially it was not Army or Air Force or Navy or BSF, but the idea was in the mind, I just wanted to become a small portion of something what my father was. Mamisha kehta tha ki mere papa jaisa banna, I want to be like him. And I was one of his biggest fan. Although I never expressed and said in those many words, but this is a fact. I wanted to be like him. So I wanted to join Army. And what I used to do when he was away on the duty or something, I used to take out his uniform from the wardrobe, wear it, fold it multiple times because he was tall and well built and I was small. And barbar wo cap laga ke, shoes pehen ke uniform, and I used to go into the mirror and I used to say, Jain sir. And I used to say, but this is what I want to become. Mujhe ye banna hai. Then I've seen him, couple of incidences happen which I've seen as a child. One which comes to my mind, I've seen my father where he was posted as an instructor in an academy and he was imparting training for the grenade throwing. One of the guys, because he lost his confidence, there was some error in his drill, whatever may be the reason, he just dropped it next to him. Without wasting a single second, I've seen him throwing that guy on the floor, picking up the grenade and throwing it. But meanwhile, it went off and he sustained severe injuries. I've seen splinter going through his body parts and other thing. And still he walked up and there was no this thing. On his face, no fear, no pain. I said, well, what kind of man he is? And thereafter, I saw in the environment how people reacted to that. Sir, you are something. So I realized, what is this and what makes man like this? I have never seen people going to that far extremes. And you see examples are numerous in army and other places.
Yes.
So that was the idea from where I thought, yes, I want to be like him. And thereafter, as a child, I used to watch three things. One was PVC. I don't know how many of you see, there was a famous series, Paramveer Chakra series, which used to be on the air on Sunday on the channel. I used to watch. That is the only channel I used to watch. And sometime, agar kabhi aisa hota tha ki light has gone off, I used to immediately pick up my cycle, go paddling for 5 kilometers, and whatever portion I could see, I used to ensure that I see that in other colony. There was no facility of YouTube, no recording facility, nothing. So that was a great motivating factor. And during the college days, I used to see two things, which was actually, you used to inspire me a lot. One was the border movie, the way it was painted. You really wanted to be in all those characters and do what these people have done. And one movie, Prahar. Have you seen this?
Yes, Prahar, yes.
Yeah, Prahar, Nana Patekar. So it was not a commercialized shape and there was a lot of reality. So when I saw that, man, this is extreme and I'm pushing yourself to the limit in commando course, that was the day I decided, I want to do this also. And I joined infantry thereafter, special forces. I did that course and I was the best student and best in physicals. I decided a long time back. So basically it was my father, the great personalities which I have seen on the channels during Paramveer Chakra series and the movies, that really motivated me a lot to join up.
Got it, sir.
So that's it.
Sir, you spoke about, your experience with your dad and, various learning that you have from various things that you saw during your childhood. Yeah. So how was your experience during the service selection board which you went through?
Okay. To be honest, it was just like a NCC integration camp for me. People coming from various parts of the country. And this is what you do in the integration camp also in NCC. People come from various parts. You share experiences, good, bad, and you learn. There are some takeaways from others. The people who are competitive, they are good from you, whether it is a drill or in personal traits. So it was good knowing new people. I enjoyed. But the only thing which I did and which I would advise aspirants also, most of the people, they go, the moment they leave their home, what is tickling into their mind is whether I will be selected or rejected. Now, this is one thought which definitely was never there in the mind till the last moment when the results were being announced. Tatak, I was absolutely chill. I was just of one idea, I just need to focus on my performance. See, selection and rejection. Usse koi farak nahi padega aapki personality. Aap jaise hain, waise rahenge. So, and second thing is, it is beyond anyone. It is somebody else's job. Somebody has been designated for, assigned for that duty. He is being paid for that. And he is quite professionally competent. So have faith in him, have faith in the system and let them do their job. You please play your part. You do your job. So for me, definition of SSB, it was just 8 to 2. 8 to 2, I used to perform the best I could in any of the tasks that was assigned to me individually or as a part of the group. After 12, I was absolutely the same college and school guy and I used to behave in the typical manner the way I was. It was only about half an hour I used to keep with me before I used to go to sleep. And a small booklet with small little self-made notes. I used to go through that and thereafter, and I used to read only for the day, which was next day and the tasks which were impending on the next day. So it was a good integration of a camp-like experience, which I really enjoyed, knowing new people. And a few of them, two of them, they got selected and they are friends. They did training with me in the same batch and they are commanding battalion today. So it was a good experience.
So there's one more thing that we, hear about, that is OLQs, that is officer-like qualities. So there are some 15 OLQs. So what is your perspective about it? Do people develop and then go, or does it eventually get developed over the training, over your, service?
Okay. You want an honest answer from me, Akash?
Yes.
Okay. The honest answer is I knew nothing about any of the OLQs. I won't say I was not bothered. I was conscious. But us have internet nahi hota tha, other facility. I probably didn't even knew what are those 15 qualities. Okay. But the definition of officer and a gentleman and about his conduct and those qualities was amply clear in my mind. Why? As I previously said, my father, I just wanted to be like him. When I look at my father, I think I will find more qualities than 15 in him. So that much I knew. कि आई जस्ट वॉन्टेड टू बी लाइक दिस ओल्ड मैन एंड आई वॉन्ट टू बी टाइगर लाइक हिम एंड मुझे ऐसा बनना है. And later on, when these facilities came and I saw that these 15 qualities, okay, I have seen on daily basis in my father. As an officer, as an individual, as a father, as a husband. And what I tell my candidates in my sessions, if you ask any of my candidates, I'm more than convinced that they'll be able to give an answer for this. I tell them on the day one, please don't get confused and don't bother too much about the OLQs, officer-like qualities. जहां तक बात रही इसको डेवलप करने की, द मंत्रा इज वेरी सिंपल. इट इज नॉट अबाउट यू नो डेवलपिंग डूइंग सम कोर्स और पर्टिकुलर एक्सरसाइजेस समथिंग देयर टू डेवलप सर्टेन क्वालिटी. इट इज ऑल अबाउट योर डेली कंडक्ट, योर डेली रूटीन.
ओके,
फॉर एग्जांपल इफ यू से ऑनेस्ट, कैन यू टेल मी और एनीवन फॉर दैट मैटर टेल मी कि व्हाट आर द एक्सरसाइज है ना, व्हाट आर द मंत्र टू बिकम एन ऑनेस्ट. आई हैव सीन कैंडिडेट्स वेयर दे मेक रिमार्क्स, आई एम ट्राइंग टू बी हंबल एंड ऑनेस्ट दीस डेज, डैम माय फॉल्ट. Either you are honest or you are not. You cannot make an attempt to become in a consciously ki I will become honest. So honesty ki definition mere dimag mein bahut clear hai. Bhai aapne life mein kuch achieve karna hai. You want to get up early in the morning, you work hard for it, slog like a horse. Aap subah time pe uthte hain, time pe apni padhai karte hain, you do good physical exercises. Aapka conduct and behavior toward the elderly people, toward the ladies, toward your counter peers is good. People say ki achha ladka hai, mehnat kar raha hai. So you डोंट रन अराउंड सीकिंग सर्टिफिकेट्स की व्हाट आर माय ओएलक्यूज. आप डेली रूटीन के अंदर अगर आपकी हैबिट्स अच्छी हैं, आपका बिहेवियर मजबूत है, ठीक है, सो इट इज ऑल अबाउट दैट. एंड विद रिगार्ड्स टू ओएलक्यू स्पेसिफिकली विद रेफरेंस टू एसएसबी, आपने चैनल्स में भी सुना होगा, यू मस्ट हैव रीड इन द न्यूज, नॉट एग्जैक्टली इन द न्यूज, ऑन अदर चैनल्स एंड ऑन गूगल. सी एसएसबी इज ऑल अबाउट थ्री थिंग्स आई कीप टेलिंग कैंडिडेट्स. वन इज मनसा, second is vachana, and third is karma, and that is all about. Mansa is what is inside your heart and head, ki ek individual kaise sochta hai, theek hai. All the psychological tests are based on this concept. When you put your pen to paper and the test is, there is a race against time. 15 second mein aapne situation ke reflexes responses dene hain, baki cheeze karni hai, aapne stories likhni hai back to back with one blank story. Okay, you have to perceive a picture, connect the dots and come up with a positive and a good theme. So, aapke man mein jo hai wo aa hi jayega bahar. That is mansa. Second is vachana. Vachana is something like what you are doing at the moment. You are the invigilator and assessor and I am the candidate. In SSB, the interviewing officer, he does only about 10 to 15% of the talking and the balance of the time is given to the candidates. So, he opens up and he gets more insight about the candidate. Yes. That is vachana. Because you need to express yourself. Bol ke batana hai aapke. And third thing is the karma. Karma is what you do, your performance on ground. That is all about the GTO task. So, agar aapki soch achhi hai, aap apni baat ko majbooti se rakhte hain, achhi baat karte hain, majbooti se aap batate hain. And ground pe jab kaam karne ki bari aati hai, whether it is an individual obstacle or it is a group task, you do well. You prove yourself to be a good leader and are a contributing effective member of the team. There is nothing looking back. So, it is as simple as that. आप अच्छा सोचिए, मजबूती से अपनी बात रखिए और ग्राउंड पे जब आता है तो गिव ए धमाकेदार परफॉर्मेंस, ठीक है. डोंट गेट बॉदर अबाउट द ओएलक्यूज. सब कुछ जो अच्छा है अपने आप निकल के आएगा इफ यू जस्ट फोकस ऑन दीज क्वालिटीज. सेकेंड थिंग विच आई विल से, यू डोंट हैव टू इंटेंशनली एंड कॉन्शियसली वर्क अपॉन समथिंग टू प्रूव ए पॉइंट. कि सर जनरली व्हाट हैपेंस इफ समबडी आस्क इन द इंटरव्यू, प्लीज टेल मी समथिंग अबाउट योर सेल्फ, व्हाट यू थिंक अबाउट योर सेल्फ, हाउ पीपल convey, sir, I am highly motivated, I have good leadership qualities, I am very punctual, I am very sincere, I am very hardworking. These are all bloody adjectives. I am meeting you for the first time, any candidate. Why should I believe? Have you done anything to prove your point? No. So it is better you prove your point on ground. And that's why it is said, action speaks louder than words. I'll just give one example. I still remember categorically, in self-description test, when it was SSB and my time came, people were asking for the extra sheet. And I wrote only one bloody sentence. The officer came to me and he said, yeah, there is a time, aap likho kuch. I said, I have written about myself and that's all I think about myself at the moment. He said, time hai, likho likho yaar. I said, ho gaya. I would like to share you know what I did. And I remember, I did it, I'm a simple guy. I'm a simple person, not guy. I'm a simple person with clean habits. Who respect his elders, loves his family and friends, and through hard work who want to achieve success in life. And that was all. What is the point writing ki I did this thing, I was best student in NCC and all that. There is a PIQ form I had filled up there. I'm sure people are wise, they will take it from there. Why should I write ki I did this thing in this sports competition or science quiz competition? Those details are very much endorsed on page 2. So there is no point repeating all this. With this sentence, at least I think it is fair to say ki at least simplicity can be seen. Ki this guy is simple, which I wrote. I started on that note. I'm a simple guy.
Yes.
The rest you can make out the way you talk, the way you present yourself. So OLQ की definition मुझे कुछ नहीं पता थी, मुझे सिर्फ ये पता था एक अच्छा बंदा होना चाहिए, which I thought कि my father, है ना, कि इनमें जो चीजें हैं वो मुझमें होनी चाहिए. I want to like be like him. So that was all. बाकी if you are asking in Angrezi generic language, I knew nothing about OLQ.
Got
that
it.
That is the honest. Yeah.
So you said you went through CDS entry. So
yeah.
Post that you went to IMA or was it an OTA?
No, I went to Officers Training Academy, Chennai.
Okay.
Yeah.
So my next question would be, you know, how was life in OTA back then? And, you know, any memories that you have which you would like to share with the audience?
Oh, those were the best days of my life. Have you heard this song?
No.
Okay. Not me, but I think you ask any officer, na, the best of the memories in his kitty, na, it will be from the academy days only. And academy mein na, there are only 3 seasons, especially in OTA. First is it is a coastal area, Chennai, very hot. So 3 seasons. First is hot.
That is correct.
Second season is hotter. And third season, I'm sure now you can make out, that is the hottest. So we had only 3 reasons. But believe me, all we had day, night and out was ragda, ragda and ragda. An amazing experience. And there are some weaklings also. There are some stalwarts also, very bold and very confident. But you always move together as a team. Jitna ragda, utna tagda. That was one thing, and we enjoyed it. And one guy, they say, you rise together, you fall apart. So academy days were the best days. And no tension, no responsibility. The only thing you need to take care, you need to be on the right place, right time and right way. That's all. And enjoy the ragda. Academy days were the best days. And today also when we get together, when postmates ikatte hote hain, believe me, 99% we are talking only of the academy days. You know, that day he bloody mugged it up. Uski wajah se ragda laga tha. Wo aisa hua tha. That is amazing day. You can comprehend only once somebody had gone through that thing.
Got it.
Lovely days. Best days of my life.
Got it, sir. So from OTA, you opted for Gorkha Rifles. So what motivated you back then, you know, to opt for it?
That is an interesting question, Akash. Again, I would like to be honest. Believe me, I never thought that I'll join Gorkhas.
Okay.
I was a damn hardcore optee of Special Forces.
Okay.
But that time our academy, AQ, he was from Gorkhas. Very smart, dynamic officer. He told me about a month in advance. Burger, you are coming to Gurkhas. I said, sir, I want to join Special Forces. He said, over my dead body. Lali, you will come to Gurkhas. I said, come on here, I have been performing well everywhere. I thought I'll get my choice. So when the final DD came and I had to fill my 3 choices, which everybody was filling. And I was also filling. And I was better in my group. People were coming and asking me to armor to nahi bhar raha. I'll become a casualty. No, I'm not going to armor. Befikar bande. He said, they are such bata. I said, seriously, I'm not opting for armor. And so I filled up Special Forces. Now that officer came to check what I had filled. He said, Dari, you have not filled Gurkhas. I said, no, sir. So it tore my application apart. He said, write Gurkhas. I have it. So when I formed Dwara Liya, I wrote Gurkhas. Then the instructor from the Special Forces, he came. He said, Dari, you're going to Gurkhas? I said, no, sir, I filled, but he told about it. He said, nothing going, but he filled Special Forces. It happened twice, thrice with me. So finally, I think I'm the only guy from my course who left all the 3 choices blank. Honestly, 1, 2, 3, no choices. Man, anyway, I'm sure God has better plans for me. So whatever I get, no, not an issue. So I left it blank. And when the results were announced, they said, okay, you've been allotted Gurkha Rifles. Great. And I was non-receptive. My course mate, Colonel Vishal Chaudhary, now, he told me, buddy, you're going to Gurkha. Gurkhas? Okay, finally, I landed up where he wanted me to. But although I landed up in the same regiment, but I never got the unit which that officer wanted me to come. Subsequently, I got to know that there is an option once you join the unit. There is an option where officer can route his application through proper channels and he can go for the Special Forces probation. So I did that. Meanwhile, I had done my models, performed very well, best in physical performance. The CEO, I'm telling you, the moment application was in old man's table, he was damn furious. He called me, and what happened thereafter inside those four walls is a very interesting story. You know, he played with me like a tennis ball, and left to right, up and down, and he sorted me nice and proper. Burger, you want to leave the Pulton? Stay back. I said, yes, sir. And thereafter, as I grew as an officer, gone through the paces and evolved as a person, as an officer, I realized, and today I would like to share this thing. Few people, they keep telling, you know, I'm from NDA, this cotton, I'm from OTA, I'm from IFA. Bullshit. Okay, while you should keep it close to your heart, and then the first love is always the first love. But over a period of time, I think we are all man serving in the combats. At least to me, it doesn't make a difference today whether you're from armored, you're from infantry, you're from medical corps, engineers, signals, or any other services or regiment. All are good. We supplement each other, we complement each other, and we are not complete without each other.
That's correct.
So when you're in combats, you are soldier first, and then these comes under your specialization areas. Now see how life runs, and life is running around in circles. After completing 15 years, when I was selected in the selection grade and picked up my rank for the full colonel, initially I was allotted some unit and field area in Assam Rifles, and then in the night I got a call. He said, you have been slotted to command one of the very elite special forces. That was the moment when I realized, you know, you keep planning whatever you want to plan in your life, but he has his own plans, and whatever he plans for us is always better than what we do plan for ourselves. So with that faith, I opted for that thing. I always wanted that maroon beret, man. This is the time. So with that service, I had gone there. I did my probation. I did my para jump course, and then did my first initial five jumps, including one night, and commanded one of the most elite force, not only in the country, but in the world, with exemplary skills. So this is how it had happened. The guy who never wanted any other unit other than special forces never got it. And when I never thought of it, it landed up in my tray. And that was the best time of my life after academy when I was in command.
Got it, sir. Sir, you would have also gone to the commando school, Belgaum, after your commissioning. So we have seen a lot of videos out there in Discovery as well, what happens there. So how was your experience when you were in commando school in Belgaum?
Now again, this is a very sore point, right? Which sometimes I complain to him, why did, you know, all these good things happens to me. But then, like I said, his plans are always better than us. Post this incident, when forces were mobilized, Op Prakram was declared, when attack happened on parliament. Mm-hmm. And when we were toward the phase out culmination point, and the units were being deinducted to their respective stations, that was the time when my posting order had come for the commando school, Belgaum, as an instructor. And I think I would have been one of the youngest in the unit that time to get that posting.
Oh, okay.
My CO, for whatever reason, for professional reasons, for personal reasons, that time, he had taken up this case with the colonel of the regiment, and he said, I want this officer to stay for more time in the unit. And he had given his own reasons. And rightly so, in his wisdom, he was a commanding officer after all. But for me, that was ultimate, and I dream. And I wanted to go to Belgaum school as an instructor. And I wanted to live that life. So his request was considered. CO has got a lot of strain. And my posting was cancelled. Okay. So posting was issued, but on special request, it was cancelled. I stayed in the unit. But see, as luck would have it, within 48 hours, I got another posting, and I moved on posting to Assam Rifles in CI operations. Again, today, when I look back, I think I learned more. On-ground experience was phenomenal. And that had happened. It was much better than going on posting, because there you are dealing only with officer on a course. In any establishment, there is a structured program, the way things happen. You know, Ustads are there, Jesus are there, officers are there. It is a very structured this thing. Things happen in auto mode. Things cannot go left and right. And you are working within a particular, you know, dimension. But when you go to counterinsurgency, you are dealing with the life situations. One decision can lead to, you know, loss of life, or it can save lives. So that was the difference. And I comprehended while it was my dream and I always wanted to do that, but God again had decided, you know, there are better things for you at plan. So you go to counterinsurgency operation and lead men. And I realized the maximum level of my confidence and everything was on the peak. I went like a cocoon when I went to first posting outside, because within regimental, this thing you are doing initially, you are in the learning phases, you are doing regimental duties. But in counterinsurgency, you are actually in charge of so many lives, a lot of responsibility. So when I came back, I actually, and I, by meanwhile, I had spread my wings and I became an absolute butterfly.
Got it.
So I had not gone to the commando school, but went on posting to Assam Rifles, NCI.
Sir, when you were a Gotha officer, so if you could tell us, you know, how was life there in terms of any ideal day, in terms of about your routine, responsibilities, how did it look like? Any ideal day?
Yeah. Again, Gurkhas are wonderful, wonderful, wonderful troops. They know, actually, being a Gurkha is not about, you know, if I had to divine, I'll say ki being a Gurkha, it is the way of living. It is a way of life, actually, if you really want to be a Gurkha. Learning a new language, speaking their language, singing songs in their language, okay, you eat what they eat, you follow all the rituals what they follow. Okay, it is a complete transformation. When I landed up in Gurkhas, I knew not even a single word. But my JCOs and NCOs, I owe a lot to them. Hats off to them. My JCOs, Subedar Hari Narayan Saab, very dynamic JCO. The old man, he told drops. I still remember, I was listening, standing outside my door, and he was telling the drops. When I joined my company at a high altitude post, he said, "Aaj ko baad mein kaise le saab sanga Hindi mein pura kare mani mein ghota kare bhai, 5 din chup." कोई पूरा करने से नहीं हिंदी में साफ साना मात्र नेपाली में पूरा करने आई थॉट पता नहीं ही इज गिविंग सम मोटिवेशन टॉक आई सेड आई एम वेरी इंप्रेसिव मैं साहब क्या बता रहा था आज मैं बड़ी ही सेड कि साहब साहब ने बोला कि अगर एक वर्ड भी हिंदी में किसी ने बोला साहब के साथ में घुटने से नीचे टांगे काटू मैं तेरी पापा आई थॉट ही इज मोटिवेटिंग ही इज थ्रेटनिंग आई सेड मैं साहब आई एम लर्निंग एंड आई एम अ गुड लर्नर बट आई रिक्वेस्ट एंड गिव बी लिटिल मोर एंड आई लीनिएंट विद मी गिव मी सम टाइम ही सेड स्कोप नहीं है साहब सीखना पड़ेगा And he used to ensure, Mandir parade hoti thi, toh dholak lekar ke sabse aage baithte the. He used to sing those songs, so that I learn it. Khana, peena, utna, baithna, sab kuch unke hisab se, but I learned very fast. So it was an amazing experience, hai na? And today people say, sir, aapki aankhe choti hai, thodi Nepali bola, aap Gurkha ho bhai? Yes, I'm a Gurkha. Then see how you transform as a person. Then Navratras, when you are in, you are at home, what do? You do puja, paath, vrat and everything. Here it is altogether 180 degree opposite. You know, you are giving balidan. Okay? Lot of non-veg and other things. But that is the way Gurkha lives. And I used to live like that only. Mm-hmm. So, it was a great transformation. I enjoyed, I learned a hell lot of things from them. The men, specific things I would like to say about Gurkhas. If you close your eyes and put your pen anywhere in the map and go to the Google and find out. You will find Gurkha troops at some point in time, whether it was World War I, II or any kind of operation, all over the globe, they have been there. They have conducted operations in the vehicles, on foot, on cycles. But you will find footprints of Gurkhas with very clear-cut, distinct, visible features everywhere. That is the footprints of Gurkhas all over the globe, not only in the country. When it comes to enjoy life, they are the people who believe if you want to learn, if you want to live your life, you should live in the present. You want to make merry, if you want to dance, sing, khush rehna hai, then you don't require a reason. Okay? Don't look for reasons to stay happy. Just stay happy. So Gurkha's experience happened very well. In army, they say, if somebody is well dressed in uniform, as an officer, as a Gurkha officer, if a Gurkha officer is standing and the officer from other regiment are standing there, you can make all the difference. You know why? When you wear the shoes, you just look at the shoes, the front part, the polish which is done on the shoes is called toeing.
Okay. Uh-huh.
That is one thing. You know, usse pata lagta hai ki ek aadmi kitni mehnat karta hoga. The way they do the shoes, how many times. But you look at them, you can actually see your face in that. Other people, sometimes they put ragzine, they put leather. Gurkhas, damn hardworking people. You know? And as they say, all good things in life comes in small packets. So, and it goes for Gurkhas. It was an amazing experience here and I owe a lot to them. I think I have become a better officer. I have become a better person in my life, and I owe the entire credit to my men, to my Jishu Sahab, to my senior subalterns, and my superiors. So they contributed a lot in my growth. I'm very thankful to them.
Got it, sir. So my next question, you know, when you joined the unit as a young officer, so how was your first combat experience and, you know, various learnings that you have from that?
Okay. Okay. Akash, I will first talk about one my mistake in a combat, and then I'll come to my combat experience. I distinctly remember the unit was deployed in J&K, in the border sector. First operation, you know, after dining out, a lot of old monk inside you, and the confidence level is high, and you are launched into some operation. So I was with my senior subaltern. I was with my subaltern, and he was also an SS officer, very dynamic officer. So hum log bahar nikle, and as a young officer just out of the academy, I was under that impression, main bas militancy kal se mera khada, and now I am on the I am on ground. That feeling comes, and I'm holding weapon in the real life situation. Firing on a standing target is different. Moving around in jungles and high altitudes and taking on action is absolutely different ball game. So I asked my senior subaltern, sir, shall I load my weapon and come into ready position? He says, hold your horses. 5 minutes, another 100 steps, again, that kira started rising. I said, sir, may I ready my weapon? He says, ruk yaar, chodo. Again, I said, main sab kari tayari. He says, ruk ja yaar. Kai baar unhone pucha, and ek time pe maine kaha nahi kar hi lete hain. I loaded my weapon. But then I forgot to take out the round. A big mistake. Finally, we were in some area, and all of a sudden, mujhe kahin thokar lagi, and that, you know, ungli trigger pe thi, and bullet went off. It went just sneaking my apna shoe. People could see, you know, dhool ud rahi hai, and ho raha tha. Everybody, they were well trained soldiers, everybody dashed down. They went down on the ground. Theek hai ki fire aaya. And I was the only one who was standing. Why? I thought, मैंने कहा भैया पहला दिन है गोली चली बट लेट गया सब बोलेंगे सब डर गया बड़े लेट ना नहीं I was not even aware कि ना I only fired the bullet everybody was down on the ground and I was standing tall मैं आज नहीं लेट ना भैया अगर लेट गए लोग बोलेंगे डर गए then my senior officer they came and said राजीव तू ठीक है मैं सब ठीक हूँ बिल्कुल he said buddy damn it when something happens you should go and touch the ground hug the ground मैं सब मैं डरता नहीं कहता डरना ठीक है but बाद में when I realized मैंने it's a stupid mistake I did that was the learning part. Now, coming to the combat experience, I'll give one example. That is not the first, but one example. It is with a purpose. Combat experience. Combat experience, mein mujhe realize hua ki all of a sudden, I am all by myself. At a young age, I'm a 22-year guy, and you have been launched into operations. You got a weapon and everything. But the most difficult part is taking a call. When to open fire? How much to fire? When to stop the fire? Which guy will be doing what task? What will be your position? How to select a team? How to plan the operation? Okay, how many teams will be going? From what all directions? It involves pretty hell lot of planning. Okay, and you can't afford that luxury to go wrong. At one point, lives are at stake. So, that was itself a great learning. And the best way to learn is when the pressure comes, you really work hard to learn things. The same thing happened with me. I was posted in the northeast. The unit recently arrived there. And I was on my move to occupy one of the company operating base, which was being vacated by previous battalion.
Okay.
So when I landed up there, because of some reasons, there was no officer, no handing takeover, no maps, nothing. Nothing was there. And things were pretty not good. So I had a look, briefed my troops, and I told them to settle down. And meanwhile, I thought, okay, it's better, I'll just go around. So I went around with a very small team. No input, nothing. Area was new in Northeast, in Assam. And I just asked somebody, so what are the news, kya chal raha hai yahan pe? And he said, ki saab, kuch suna to hai. That was all, which was told to me. With four guys, I kept looking for more input, moving from place A to B and then C and likewise. I reached a moment where I was left alone and there was no one with me. Then I wanted more troops. Communication, we were out of the communication range. So I sent the vehicle back, called for a vehicle, JSU Saab, and another couple of people with communication devices. And they were spread at least over a stretch of 20 kilometers at different locations. And finally, they said, ki, sir, wo banda and those things and thing will be recovered in that area. And itni jagah bande phail chuke the, I was getting only lead, more input, but no results. Finally, it was only my driver and self. And those two guys who have been apprehended so far. So only two guys, not aware, kitne bande hai, kya kuch hai. And we landed up there. And he said, ki, this is the house, this is the situation. And only two people. But jab pressure aata hai, dimag chalta hai. There were people. So I said, okay, fine. So we made the announcement. You have been cordoned. Hai na? And the moment you do anything for any, you are done. So finally, people had given up. So we recovered a lot of war stores without firing single bullet. Without single bullet was fired, but they succumbed to the pressure. The environment, that thing was created for them. You have been surrounded. They didn't know it is only two guys and we are playing dirty with them. But it worked. So we got good four apprehensions and we recovered a lot of warlike stores. This was the first day within first 24 hours when I reached there. So it was a great input and it contributed toward citation later on to my unit also. CO, the commander, they visited the post very next day and they say, ki, it is a damn good company and the commander is in the safe hands. And I want to meet this officer. And within 24 hours, when they are into settling down process, they could do something like that. So it was a great experience.
Got it, sir.
So most of the people, most of the people they talk about, you know, the definition of combat experience, you know, how he felt like when he killed the first guy. You know, life is beyond all this. There is no fun in killing. You know? In Forge also, the teaching teaches you, the value teaches you. The aim is to apprehend someone if it is possible. If not, then you injure him and try to catch him, put him through the legal process. And when the situation is inevitable and you know it can lead to loss of life, then you don't think twice and you get him down. So that's why purposely I had not spoken anything about killing and all that. You know, while that is a call of the duty, but it is not a very pleasant experience, you know, to talk about it.
Got it.
Yeah.
So you have been in multiple combats. So if I can ask you, what was your favorite weapon which you used to use?
Oh.
Which you like?
Okay. Before that, Akash, may I ask, what is your favorite weapon?
Oh, mine, I have heard about people that AK is the best, but of course, because all of us like special forces, so Tavar is also one of the favorite.
Okay. Fine. Okay. If you ask me, what is your favorite weapon? I think it is my heart.
Okay.
Okay. And my mind. I keep telling my candidates, I have always told this thing to my officers and my men also. You know, it doesn't matter what weapon you are holding. At the end of the day, it is always the bloody man who is standing behind the machine. Suppose AK-47 is given to both of us. We both are holding the same specification, same weapon. But the man standing behind the machine, I might kill an innocent because of the fear, you know, because of the poor decision capability, the dilemma. Okay, or my poor firing skills, whatever may be the reasons. On the contrary, there is a man like you, you know, who is very calm and composed. He takes the correct decisions. You know, and he try to first threaten him, then try to injure him, and then subsequently, if required, neutralize him. I fire 10 rounds and can't take a single shot with that AK-47 on the target. On the contrary, there is a man like you who hold the weapon, do the correct breathing exercise, aim correctly, and hit all but 10 bullets in the bull. Now you tell me who is better.
The man who's calculating properly, the man behind the weapon.
So, I would not say it is not a, it's a good question, but I'm just sharing my perspective. It is always the man behind the machine that makes a difference. Why I said, so this is my perspective from the mind. Heart, I said why. Heart, I'm saying it is the biggest weapon. I'll give you two specific examples. It's impromptu that is coming to my mind. Number one. In SAI operation, there was a guy. We were in a situation where actually it was just for a moment, but like 1 second and he would have been in a bit too fair. But all of a sudden, then I saw some lady came and she was, you know, hugging my legs. So I looked at him and the first this thing was ki lady is in the family way. Probably she is pregnant. Then I settled down. I said, please don't do this, Didi, I'm bad here. And then I spoke to her She was speaking something in Manipuri. I spoke to the people, people translated. I got to know that she is on the family way and she is due for delivery in a day or two. There was no one in the family from his side or the wife's side. She was all by herself. So I said, well, there is no reason, Anna. And now since we have nabbed him, Anna, never it will happen. So few people were of that idea. No, no, we can do that. But I was very clear in my concern. I said, no, it is not going to happen. So I admitted that lady in the hospital, borne all the expenses for her delivery and everything. And after 1 month, I told him, you know, your son, you know, before he even is born, in a, he can be an orphan. Only because of you. Had you been shot today. But we are not going to do anything like that. So it is better. You know, a quick kranti nahi aayegi. There are ways to do things. And you are a young guy. And he was actually a young guy. Just about, I think, 26, 28. So, man, please, and give yourself a fair chance. And there are better things in life. Try to improve. And we deposited him in the legal procedure. After 3 months, then he visited my post along with his wife. You know for why? He said, ki, sir, he's my son and we want you to name him. And what about you? You're still doing adventures? He said, no, sir, I'm out of that. I'm just trying to do something decent in life. I started a small shop and this is what I'm doing. So, you tell me. And I'm asking you, what do you think? With the weapon of the heart, this is the better you bring someone from that line to the mainstream. This is more effective.
Yes.
But if you would have been knocked down, I don't think, you know, that weapon is worth it. So that's why the heart. Second, talking about my own men, my own fraternity. I've seen my men. Log bolte hain command mein bahut challenges hote hain, bahut mushkil hota hai. And main hamesha kehta hu logon ko, hamesha kehta tha officers ko, believe me, command has been the easiest part of my journey in the services. Why? All you require, you just need to wear your heart on your sleeve. Aap jaise ho logon ko dikhna chahiye ki banda aisa hai. If your heart is majboot and it is at the right place, you don't have to worry for anything. Things will fall into place. Aapko bolne ki bhi zarurat nahi hoti if your right heart is in the right place. People know you, they can feel you. Okay? And you just take one step, the entire team follows you blindly. So I'm very convinced and confident about what I just said. The best weapon in my wisdom is your heart and your mind. Ek achha man hona chahiye aur ek achha dimag hona chahiye. That's it.
Got it.
I might be sounding philosophical, but this is actually the truth. Agash, what I'm telling you.
Yes, yes. Got it.
Weapon aaj ek achha hai, tomorrow you get a better shade in the market. But you don't get energy, heart ka, you get a better version. You have to build it. Based on your experiences, you have to make. That's an indigenous product. You have to create it, make it by yourself.
That's correct.
That's an all an imported and exported, you know, weapon inventory. There's a difference.
True. Huh? That.
Yeah.
Sir, I also see one of your photos in the background where you're wearing a maroon beret. So, if you could tell the story of your first paratrooping experience that you had when you jumped out of an aircraft.
Would love to. Okay. If you really want to define that thing, it is actually very difficult, you know, to comprehend. It is something like, you know, somebody has gone to swimming pool, you tell him, to josh mein pehli tang to nikalti hai. But it is very difficult. You feel like it is stuck up to, you know, pick up the second leg and go out in this thing. And that is just about 10 meters. So imagine, you know, you are jumping from that height at barely hundreds of speed when the aircraft is flying with lots of load. Aapke aage as a result parachute on the back, between your legs, with a weapon, very difficult. But it is a very thrilling and adventurous experience. I really enjoyed it. And again, it is all about perspective. I remember when we were doing apna probation. So once you are done your training, they take you for first apna on-air experience. So we were taken. There was a guy. And people are watching, you know, like what he feels, what he experiences. And even if there is a gulp in your neck, people say the Bentley is not prepared. So they pull him back. So I remember there was a guy and they asked him, kya niche kya dikh raha hai? Usne niche dekha and I don't say ko bolna chahta, but uske muh se nikla bola mouth. The moment he said ki bhai isko piche khencho bada, but ye khud bhi karega, dusro ko marwa sakta hai. Then my turn came and he said, sab niche aapko kya dikh raha hai? Main absolutely amazing, very orgasmic. Maja aa gaya. He said, okay, theek hai sir. So it was a great experience. But until unless you had gone through that rigorous training, where you trained so very hard, ki sham tak, I remember, pehle 3 din ke andar, my neck was so stiff, jump, practice, daire jump, aage jump, piche jump, hawa ke parkhilaaf idhar jump, ki my neck was absolutely stiff. So I still remember my commander, he was doing apna probation with me only. So he said, Rajiv, And I looked like this. Sir, he said, buddy, why are you moving like this? Sir, believe me, it is not an attitudinal problem. You know, it was the training. It was a good training experience. And I would say my experience would have been a little different from other paratroopers, especially not for me, but for anyone who has commanded these elite units. There is a norm we follow. Whenever it comes to jump, the commanding officer of the battalion is always the first one to jump. You always lead by example. The moment you exited and you are in there, people don't think twice. And just less than a fraction of a second, people go outside and go, 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 go. That is the momentum. So leading men and taking that call and moving and doing the exec first for the aircraft is a better way of doing it. I learned that thing. And if I had to compare it with anything else, any other adventurous activities, I will tell you. And I normal SMM parafraternity people say like this. Rest any of the games, whether it is a basketball, volleyball, baseball, take a golf, anything. In all these games, you require only one ball. This is the bloody only game in sports in which you require actually two balls, you know. So that says what kind of sports you are leading into. It's an amazing experience. I loved it. And given me a chance, I assure you, Akash, you give me a call at the midnight and give me an offer to jump, you will always find me ready with my parachute on. And so back to you. Yeah.
Sir, you are a commanding officer and you have led men into operations and led men in the unit itself. So what does leadership mean to you? And you know, how Army helped you develop those skills?
Okay. If I talk in a very simple manner, leadership is nothing very great, but it is just influencing in a mass, a group of people. Okay. You inspire them through your own example and take it to a level where they willingly perform those duties to accomplish a goal which is given to them. If people, they do it willingly as a team to accomplish a goal and you can achieve that, that is called leadership. You said, has Army contributed? I'm telling you immensely. I don't have words enough to express and to tell you how much Army had contributed in my involvement if I talk about the leadership. I owe everything to this great organization. Whatever I am today, it is only because of this elite organization. Now, how it has contributed? Okay. The first part is the training. In the training, you are taught, you know. In the training, there are a lot of difficult conditions. It teaches you how to be a good leader, how to influence people. I still remember, in academy, the toughest thing is 2.4 kilometer. You are actually in race against time. 2.4 kilometer is damn difficult. I was one of those who was extremely good in physicals because I remember when I joined academy and first time only I came first in the cross country in my battalion, even before my seniors. But I realized 2.4 is a different ball game together. So I finished it and then it was my training which taught me that there's a guy who's lagging behind. So there was one of the coursemen I ran behind and he said, ki, I can't do it. Main ho jayega. He said, nahin, nahin ho payega. And I went back. And I got hand of him and I was going to catch him. He was just absolutely, he said, we mar gaye. But I met him, he came from abroad. He is in civil domain today. And he came and he told my son, you know, the best memory I have, this guy is something. He not only finished this, but he came back and but he pulled me and ensured that I crosses the line. So training is one thing which helps you a lot. You know, it teaches you how you can motivate others, how you can inspire others. And second and the biggest thing, what I'll say, is the responsibility. When you are assigned responsibility, okay, it definitely and it helps you a lot to further hone down your skills and inculcate those leadership qualities. For example, for a moment, let's not talk about the army. Okay. I'll talk about you in person. In your family, who's the head of the family?
My dad.
Your dad. Now, more than anybody, and he has got a lot of responsibility, whether it is on the financial front, whether it is in the caretaking of every member of the family, whether it is about your education or career, whether it is the health aspect, everything. There are a lot of responsibility or the maximum responsibility is on the mukhya of the family, isn't it? So to accomplish all this and also to ensure and get everyone willingly to do their best to accomplish a task. Ki, Akash, bida, aapne achche se padhai karni hai, you have to do this, you have to accomplish this. आपने ये करना है, ठीक है, और योर ब्रदर और योर सिबलिंग्स, यू नो रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी टीचेस यू अ लॉट थिंग. सेम वे इन आर्मी, व्हेन यू ज्वाइन यू गेट अ कमांड ऑफ 120 मैन, दैट इज अ कंपनी. ठीक है, देन इट कम्स बड़ी बटालियन, ठीक है, सेकंड इन कमांड, देन कमांडिंग ऑफिसर, ब्रिगेडियर, एंड लाइक वाइज. एज यू कीप ग्रोइंग इन द रैंक इन द सर्विस, है ना, द नंबर ऑफ द मेन, द नंबर ऑफ द रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटीज कीप मल्टीप्लाई. और जब जिम्मेदारी आपके ऊपर आती है, देर इज नो सेकेंड वे अदर देन टू बी ए गुड लीडर. इफ यू डोंट नो समथिंग, यू लर्न इट योरसेल्फ, सो दैट यू कैन प्रूव अ पॉइंट कि डैम गाइस, बट आई एम बेटर देन यू. ठीक है,
गॉट इट, गॉट इट.
आई विल गिव वन एग्जांपल फॉर दिस अबाउट द लीडरशिप. व्हेन आई वाइंडेड अप माय इनिंग्स फ्रॉम असम राइफल्स, आई लैंडेड अप बैक इन माय यूनिट. आई गॉट टू नो दैट देयर वाज अ competition. I don't know whether you guys are aware of it or not. It is called Cambrian Petrol. Cambrian Petrol competition. Search for it in the Google. You will get to know the details.
Mm-hmm.
A very rigorous, tough, damn bloody competition. Cambrian Petrol. I had no idea. Busy in CIA operation. मैंने कहा ये क्या बकवास है? बोला सर एक competition होता है, उसमें ना इतना दौड़ते हैं. अच्छा कितना? बोला सर 30 किलोमीटर. मैं बड़े chicken shit, nothing. He said मैं क्या हुआ? बोला सर वो brigade. Brigade में हम लोग last आए. Brigade means 3 battalions, 3 infantry battalions.
Mm-hmm.
Gurke, hum log we are good at certain things, we are good at boxing. We are good at football. We are good at the music equipment. But, you know, running and all this thing is not our forte, endurance, whatever. Maybe we are not good. So, I am ready to accept this. I had a different view of this. As a not acceptable to me. As infantry unit, if you cannot do only this task, then I am sorry. I am very confident about it. But who says that Gurkhas can't do it? I said, sir, वैसे तो मैं जाट हूँ, ठीक है? But by karma and dharma, I am very confident and convinced about it. I am a Gurkha first and then a Jat. You see, any of my t-shirt, I used to write on every t-shirt, Gurkha Jat. This is how it used to read. If you see one of my photographs where I am holding my son and gone to, you can see on my t-shirt also written Gurkha Jat.
Okay.
Then I had a battalion fallen. Hit them, motivated them, hit them below the belt also. Said something. I said, I want volunteers. They were not many. They knew that I will butcher them. Then one guy, he walked up to me. He said, sir, I'm very just mediocre guy. I'm just saddle factory mein aata hu main, BPT mein, but I would love to do it with you. My good. I just want volunteers. I'll train you guys. So I had to create one team. I created two. I kept reserve of my army. I started. The senior was not on talking terms with me. He was annoyed. Okay, I made statement like that. Okay. Couple of months, we did not speak. I started my training. 30 की बजाय मैंने उनको पहले 10 किया, फिर 50, फिर उसका 100, फिर 150 किलोमीटर भी दौड़ाया मैंने उनको. पिट्ठू के लिए आई रिमेम्बर बीएसएफ के पुराने जो कंडम स्टोर थे वो पिट्ठू लेकर के आया, उसमें स्टिचिंग कराई, उनके साइज के हिसाब से पट्टे वगैरह सब कुछ बनाया. एंड आई स्टार्टेड माय ट्रेनिंग. जिसको स्विमिंग नहीं आती थी उन सबको स्विमिंग सिखाई, पहले पॉन्ड में लेके फिर लोकल नदी में लेकर के. एंड दिस वाज द वे आई केप्ट ऑन ट्राइंग देम. आई पुश देम टू देयर मैक्सिमम लिमिट्स. एंड व्हेन the competition came, there was a unit which was participating against, I'll not name the unit, and wo isse pehle is insurgency area ke andar they had participated in a very high hilly area and undulating ground, and one of the boy because of exhaustion had died. They said come what may, he had lost his life for the Paltan, we have to bloody do it. And when a man dies, his body becomes heavier. I'm sure you are aware of this fact. वो लोग डेड बॉडी को उठाकर के दौड़े, उसके बाद में दे क्लोज्ड इट इन द फर्स्ट पोजीशन. सबसे बड़ी स्ट्रॉन्ग टीम वाज माय कंपटीटर अगेन. एंड द ब्यूटी वाज इट वाज अ जाट यूनिट. इट वाज अ जाट यूनिट. एंड देन कंपटीशन रिजल्ट्स वर आउट, वी वर फर्स्ट एंड दे वर रन अप. सो दिस यू वॉकड अप टू मी, आई वाज मेजर साहब दैट टाइम विद 8 इयर्स ऑफ सर्विस. एंड ही सेड गेट द हैट्स ऑफ टू यू टाइगर. मैं सर व्हाट हैपेंड? ही सेड आई आस्क्ड इन सैनिक सर्विस, माय बड़ी गाइस अगेन वी विल क्रैक दिस शो. ही सेड नहीं साहब, इस बार तो कुछ अलग सीन है, वो बड़ा सरफरा आदमी है. एंड सब फर्स्ट तो वही आएंगे, बाकी सेकंड हम आएंगे, बाकी उनके लिए राम कहानी है. आकाश उसके बाद में वी वन ब्रिगेड, देन वी वन डेव कमांड कोर, एंड देन कमांड, एंड फाइनली वी वर द आर्मी चैंपियनशिप. एंड माय टीम वाज स्लॉटेड एंड नॉमिनेटेड टू रिप्रेजेंट इंडियन आर्मी एंड इंडिया एंड कैम्ब्रियन पेट्रोल कॉम्पिटिशन इन वेल्स. in London, at London. However, things were different. Again, God has planned for me. Went to army headquarters, everything planned. There was tickets confirmed, passports made, everything. And at the last minute, it had to be cancelled for whatever reasons. But I'm still very happy ki I proved my point ki Gurkhas can do it. There was a question you asked now. Tell me about Gurkhas. This is what Gurkhas is. We started from zero and we became the national hero.
That's nice.
That is Gurkhas. Gurkhas can do it.
Yeah.
And when it is a Gurkha jat, it is even deadlier combination. You know?
Yeah.
I'm sorry, what was your initial question? What you asked me?
About leadership, actually.
Yeah, about leadership. Yeah. Okay, I'm sorry. So this is all about leadership. With the correct weapon in your hand, that is your heart and mind. And if you do it, this is what people are capable to achieve, you know, and you need to give that credit to them. This is about leadership. I started from where and the seniors had no faith, we cannot do it. Men were not volunteer, they said we cannot do it. It was complete 1 year dedicated effort. And I would specifically like to name one of my team members, Charlie Company Agari.
Okay.
This guy, he was one of the toughest nut, but he was diagnosed with some problem. He did not even share it with me. He underwent an operation of appendicitis and wrapped a lot of dirty cotton bundles around his waist so that I don't get to know and bleeding can be stopped. Finally, I got to know, मैंने बड़ा समझाया and he actually cried. He said, "Ji sir, please बहुत मेहनत करी. At least, ना, let me participate in the court level, then I'll take rest. But please don't deny me." It was taking chances. You know, it was so difficult to say no to him, fully knowing that something can happen. And I'm sure, even शायद command में भी नहीं पता होगा लोगों को आज तक कई लोगों को ऐसा कुछ हुआ था. But he deserves recognition, so I'm citing his name.
Got it.
He settled somewhere in Nepal today.
Sir, the last question from my end is, you know, a lot of aspirants are watching us right now. So what will be your message to all of them? Also, because you also train people for SSB, how can they actually contact you? If you could briefly tell us about that as well.
Okay. See, SSB ka bahut bada hawa bana rakha logon ne. When I see in different YouTube channels and other things, a lot of people, and they give good advices, but a lot of people, they speak which make only one sense to me, and that is nonsense. I'm not against anyone, neither I'm advocating anyone, neither I'm saying that I'm better than anybody else. You know, but aap jis shiddat se kaam karte hain, wo zarur farak dalti hai aapki nazariye mein. You know, one thing is coaching. Jahan pe bhi ek coaching word aata hai, I have a personal problem with this. I feel it is a commercialized shit, you know, coaching. The preferred word is the training that I use. Training demands a lot of personal involvement. सबसे पहला मेरा एडवाइस ये है एस्पिरेंट्स को जो तैयारी करते हैं द थ्री वर्ड्स व्हिच आई टोल्ड देम मनसा कर्मा एंड वचना ठीक है आप इन चीजों पे फोकस कीजिए डोंट बॉदर अबाउट द ओएलक्यूज आप जैसे हैं अच्छे हैं मैं हमेशा बोलता हूं अपने कैंडिडेट को अपनी ओरिजिनलिटी को बना के रखिए सिर्फ काम करने का जो तरीका है वो फर्क होता है नो तो आप अच्छा सोचिए अच्छा अच्छे तरीके से अपनी बात बोलिए छोटा सा सवाल है उसको बहुत लेंदी वर्बोस बताता है बंदा Develop this habit of speaking more and less words. You know? Okay. Second thing is daily routine. As I say, ki, you know, army, while other professions, they might offer you a very glorious and a very good and a promising career. But what army offers you, it offers you life. A lot of difference. And that's, it is up to you. You want a career or you want a life? You want a life, please join combats. Army. So, आप ओएलक्यू के बारे में चिंता मत कीजिए आप अपना डेली रूटीन अपना हैबिट्स ठीक है वहां से शुरुआत कीजिए आप सुबह 8 बजे उठते हैं 9 बजे उठते हैं योर ओवर वेट आप बड़े बड़े बाल रखते हो ठीक है आप पढ़ाई लिखाई नहीं करते आप न्यूज़पेपर नहीं पढ़ते हो योर जनरल अवेयरनेस इज वेरी पुअर पेरेंट्स आपको बहुत टोकते हैं ठीक है समझाते हैं बट आप अपनी करते हैं सो प्लीज स्टार्ट फ्रॉम योर होम स्टार्ट फ्रॉम योर सेल्फ स्टार्ट वर्किंग अपॉन योर सेल्फ आप सुबह टाइम पे उठिए कीप योर थिंग्स इन वेरी ऑर्गेनाइज मैनर Follow a good schedule, ठीक है and be well dressed, ठीक है अपना कंडक्ट अच्छा कीजिए आपके पेरेंट्स आपको खुद ही बता देंगे कि बच्चे में बड़ा फर्क है बड़ा टाइम लगता है आपके अड़ोस पड़ोस में बोलेंगे आपको बच्चा बड़ी मेहनत कर रहा है पक्का कुछ करेगा सो डोंट प्लीज लुक फॉर सर्टिफिकेट फ्रॉम अकेडमीज एंड फ्रॉम मेरा उस्ताद की सर मेरा हो जाएगा क्या अरे आपको खुद पे भरोसा होना चाहिए अगर आप डिसाइड करोगे पक्का होगा लेकिन आप दूसरों से ही सर्टिफिकेट लेते रहोगे कि सर वो हुआ नहीं मेरी स्टोरी कहीं गड़बड़ हो गई प्लीज फोकस On yourself, polish yourself. फौज में काम आते बड़ी सिंपल सी जूता और शरीर आपका दिमाग आप जितना रगड़ोगे उसमें उतनी चमक आएगी सो प्लीज पॉलिश योर सेल्फ ठीक है थर्ड थिंग देखो सिलेक्शन एंड रिजेक्शन इज जस्ट अ पार्ट ऑफ द एसएसबी प्रोसीजर, ठीक है। जो आदमी सेलेक्ट होता है ही सेज गुड थिंग्स, जो नहीं हो पाता किसी वजह से है ना, ही प्रॉब्ली फाइंड फॉल्ट एट टाइम्स, डोंट डू दैट, हैव फेथ इन द सिस्टम, ठीक है। इट्स अ वेरी ट्रांसपेरेंट सिस्टम, ठीक है, एंड कोई संभावना ही नहीं कि कोई आदमी अपना काम है ना गलत तरीके, दे आर हाईली प्रोफेशनली कॉम्पिटेंट पीपल, ठीक है, एंड दे वर्क विद अ वेरी सिंपल एम। Anybody who's sitting in the SSB, they are sitting only to handpick and select good people, few good men. Yes. If you have it in you, they will select you. Again, and they are always looking for the fittest guy for this finest organization. If you are one of them, there is no reason anybody will reject you. So, kabhi agar nahi ho pata hai, to don't please lose heart. Again, that is the worst thing. Ek acha doctor, ek acha ustad, ek acha mentor, jo aapko de sakta hai, the best thing he can give you good training and hope. Again. So, जो नहीं होता तो उसके बाद में कुछ लोग हथियार डाल देते हैं, वेरी मच अगेंस्ट दिस, पता नहीं सर हो ही नहीं पा रहा, कई बार गए थे। नो, एक इंग्लिश में देयर इज अ ब्यूटीफुल सेइंग, ड्रीम्स डज नॉट हैव एन एक्सपायरी डेट, ठीक है, एंड सिलेक्शन एंड रिजेक्शन इट इज ऑल इन योर हेड। इफ यू थिंक यू आर गोइंग टू सक्सीड, यू विल, प्रोवाइडेड यू वर्क सिंसियरली अपॉन दैट, ठीक है, एंड इफ यू डोंट वर्क, तो आप कितना भी सोचते रहो, द रिजल्ट्स विल नॉट है ना टर्न आउट द वे यू वॉन्ट टू बी। So please work hard, ठीक है, keep things simple in life, don't get into too much of this thing, कि कैसे करना है, आप अपना routine ठीक रखिए, अपने habit और conduct अच्छा कीजिए, that is one, don't focus too much on selection and rejection, but please focus on your efforts, ठीक है, and you will see the results coming, ठीक है, OLQ के बारे में नहीं बोलूंगा, but तीसरी चीज ये है कि you are the person who knows best, कि आपके weak areas किधर हैं, not weak areas, but areas for improvement, कि आप थोड़ा शर्माते हैं, आपको कम्युनिकेशन स्किल्स में काम करने की जरूरत है, ठीक है, आपको जनरल अवेयरनेस बढ़ाने की जरूरत है, यू नीड टू लूज अ लिटिल वेट, है ना, बी फिजिकली मोर एक्टिव, सो प्लीज आइडेंटिफाई दोज एरियाज एंड वर्क अपॉन दैट। आप अगर वो ईमानदारी से काम करोगे, आपका कॉन्फिडेंस बढ़ेगा, आपकी प्रोबेबिलिटी भी सिलेक्शन की बढ़ेगी, ठीक है। सो एट द एंड, आकाश, फ्रॉम माई साइड आई विश यू एंड ऑल द पीपल ऑन बोर्ड ऑल द वेरी बेस्ट इन योर फर्दर इनिंग्स। I wish all the best things in life that life has to offer and which I probably can feel, wish for myself. So wish you guys fair winds and happy landings always. God bless and Godspeed. Jain.
Jain, Jain, sir. Thank you. Thank you for being on this session, sir. I'll just spend 2 more minutes. Let's see if somebody has a question which is not covered. If not, then you're good, sir. Well, give me one second.
Please, sir. I would like to, love to take on. Yeah.
Yeah, if anybody who's listening to us and has any other question which is not covered, can put it on the comment. Sir will take it up. You can put it on the comment if you have any. Otherwise, let's see if I see anything. Okay, I do not see anything.
That's a happy situation. Actually, I keep telling candidates, na, class mein jab aap jawab dete ho, answer dena is the easiest part. You learn something, you cram on and then uske baad mein you just vomit. But asking question is actually the difficult part, you know. But anytime anybody want, the last thing, what you said, ki, how people can contact me?
That question, yes.
Akash, to be very honest, I'm not very active on the social media. People reaches out to me and that is how I get connected. I believe in personal connect rather than doing any marketing or something. But I don't want to dilute my thought process, my standards and anything. Telephone is one thing, mobile, on which people can contact me. My number is given on my Insta account. That is Colonel_Bharwan. Bharwan. And my phone number on which people can contact me is 9685311098. Otherwise, with my name, I'm available on the mail also, rajibharwan@gmail.com. The second email ID is soldierunplugged68, that is my course, @gmail.com.
Got it, sir.
So if you want to get in touch, you'll always find me around the corner.
Yeah. Thanks a lot, sir. Sir, I don't see any question coming up right over here. So I think we're good to close. I'd like to thank you again for your time on this session. And I hope a lot of people who have watched us now and who will be watching us on YouTube will learn a lot of things from all the experience that you have shared with us. So
thank you so much. Really means all the world to me. Thank you so much, Akash. God bless.
Thanks a lot, sir. Bye-bye.
Jai. God bless. Thank you, dear. Thank you, buddy. Thank you so much.
Bye-bye.